Tommy Dolan and Mike Parisi. The timekeeper is George Bannon. Counting for the knockdowns, Joe Pushkow. Your referee for the main event, Teddy Martin. 10 rounds. From Santa Clara, Cuba, wearing black trunks, weighing 148, Benny Kid Pate. His opponent from Mexicali, Mexico, wearing white trunks, weighing 148 and a half, Gaspar Ortega. Ortega, main event, 10 rounds, another bout to follow.
Make sure he's made to understand what I'm about to say. Both you boys boxed in New York State before. I know that you know the rules of our commission. But remember, we apply the mandatory eight-count knockdown rule. If you happen to score the knockdown, you walk to the farthest noble corner, stay there until I finish my count, and I'll wave you in and resume boxing. If you score three knockdowns in any one round, the fight ends right then and there. Now you punch with one hand, three, provide you're not punching, hold him with the other. Now shake hands, make sure you come up.
Peppers it for him.
Yes.
This is the third Cuban fighter. The other two Cubans tonight were beaten, which was a surprise. Doug Valiant from Havana was defeated by Chico Rollins, and Kid Fachiki from Havana was defeated by Emil Griffith. The two Cuban fighters and the two 10-rounders were beaten. Now Benny Kid Parrott in black against Gaspar Ortega in white. Main event from Madison Square Garden. Parrott in black from Cuba is the favorite. Throw a lot of combinations. 5, 6, 8, 10 punches in a row. Look at that. Beautiful. These are the styles the fans like. A lot of leather flying. Right by Ortega. This Cuban can take a punch. One minute to the end of round one on your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports, coming from Madison Square Garden. That's Teddy Martin, the referee tonight. And there, according to these styles, it looks we're in for a good bristling fight. Beautiful round, a lot of action, and that's the end of round one.
Hey, Jimmy, what's new?
What's new? The biggest shaving news since the turn of the century. The new 195 Gillette adjustable razor.
See this micrometer adjustment?
you turn to any one of 9 different stops to match your skin and beard. At the lower settings, you expose less blade edge. Up and up goes the edge exposure as you turn the collar. Between 1 and 9, there's a stop that's just right for you. Light beard, average beard, heavy dense beard. Tender skin, you call it, no matter what, here's the answer. And talk about comfort. Man, you're really living when you shave with this remarkable new razor. And it loads and unloads in a jiffy. So try this amazing razor on our positive money-back guarantee. A nearby store has the 195 Gillette adjustable razor with dispenser of Gillette Blue Blades and handsome travel case for only $1.95.
Most boxers from outside the United States like to wear white ring shoes. The American boys usually wear black. So we have a Cuban and a Mexican tonight in the main event on your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports. Take a look at the Cuban, Benny Parrott. He was born in Bernardo, Santa Clara, Cuba, in March, just a few days after Henry Armstrong made his first New York appearance in this ring. He's called Nardo by his friends. He's a hard-hitting boy. He's 5'9", the son of Albert, a sugar field worker, and Maxima Parrott. He has 4 sisters and 1 brother. As an amateur, he worshipped Kid Gavilan. He won 28 out of 29, likes baseball. He started his fighting career, won his first 15 fights. He calls himself a boxer-puncher, has a sharp left hook. First to defeat the wild bullet, Salazar. He's won 27 of 33, lost 5, and had 1 draw. Remember, on Friday night, August 28th, Gillette will bring you the 15-round middleweight championship bout between Carmen Basilio and Gene Pullman from the Cow Palace in San Francisco. Basilio fight is Friday, August the 28th. It'll be over these same stations except for the San Francisco area, which will be blacked out on TV. hard to believe that Henry Armstrong and Mike Beloys were fighting in this same ring a few days after this Cuban was born. He's 22. Similar styles, toe-to-toe and lots of punches. And a varied attack. Notice how they shift from the body, uppercuts to the head, jabs. One minute to the end of round three. Ortega's had 66 fights. He's only 23. Ortega, who had that big round, was once a cowboy. He aspired to be a bullfighter, and he's the world's fifth-ranking welterweight. But there's so much enthusiasm for Cuban fighters here that the Cuban was the favorite, a slight favorite, when they went into the ring. These exchanges. the style the fans love. No clinching, no stalling, just working 3 minutes out of every round. Crowd is applauding. That's their compliment here. They're a very, very enthusiastic crowd. Ortega, we've watched him from our ringside seat here against Rudy Stitch, Mickey Crawford, Isaac Logart, Tony DeMarco, and Kid Gavilan. His best performance was against the welterweight champion Don Jordan. Only a few points was the difference. He was born in Mexicali. His early ambitions were to become a bullfighter, and I wonder with all the news about accidents in recent bullfights if he doesn't think boxing a much easier sport. One of his top rooters is an old friend, General Humberto Morillis, one of the Mexican equestrian team who performed many times in the garden here in the horse show, one of the best goodwill ambassadors Mexico ever had. Gaspar Ortega, 23 years old, 66 fights, 149, last fight in June, stopped Ray Terrazas at Juarez. Kid Parrott, 22 years old, 33 fights, 127, his last fight in June, he defeated Rudy Sawyer. Cowboy. He's a lieutenant in the Mexican Reserve Army. Advice floating around here, La Cocina, in the kitchen or in the belly, and that's where Ortega, however, is hitting the Cuban. Use the right. One minute to the end of round five. This is your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports. A good fight coming your way. A corker from Madison Square Garden. Two beautiful lefts. Left hook to the belly, left hook to the chin, and that's the end of the round. Thank you. Friday, your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports presents heavyweights Alonzo Johnson and Alex Mitev from Madison Square Garden. Johnson, he's rated number 8. He has an excellent jab and hook. He's the former national AAU champion and Golden Glove champion. He comes to the Garden with a streak of 12 straight. He's lost only one professional fight, 117. Mitev, he was born in Argentina. He's always dangerous because of his punch and aggressiveness. Pan-American heavyweight champion, he's been likened to Lewis Angel Firpo. This year, he scored a spectacular two-round knockout of Harold Carter, lost only three professional fights, 118. That's next Friday. Now remember, on Friday, August the 28th, Gillette will bring you the 15-round middleweight championship bout between Carmen DeFilio and Gene Fulmer from the Cow Palace, San Francisco. Friday, August 28th, over the same stations except for the San Francisco area, which will be blacked out on TV. Wrestling fight. Teddy Martin lets them fight their way out of these clinches. A good referee helps make a good fight better by leaving the punchers alone. Ortega. Ortega is very popular, very durable. One minute, the end of round 7. Shape. They've been going at it like this, in case you just tuned in, ever since round 1. The beauty of the fight. Thank you. Henry saying, I'll trade a ride with you, you'll trade a ride with me. Ortega always gets lower and is not so vulnerable in a lot of those exchanges. The Cuban fights straight up most of the time. That's one of the axioms of ring fighting. If your opponent gets low, you get lower. We're having a resurgence of Cuban fighters here. They're very colorful, very popular. The last time they fought here, all three Cubans won. But tonight, the two Cubans that were on ahead lost. Kid Pachiki was beaten by Emil Griffith, who's undefeated. Douglas Vaillant, also from Cuba, was defeated by Chico Rollins. Now, 29 years ago tonight, I sat in a ringside seat at the Polo Grounds watching another Cuban in action. He'd been undefeated in his first 66 pro fights. And as Kid Chocolate, he was indeed a sweet boy to watch. But that evening against Jackie Berg, gave away too much. 36,000 fans saw him get beat. And when the decision was announced by Joe Humphries, Kid Chocolate put his arms across the top rung of ropes and began to cry. His manager, Louis Gutierrez, screamed a high heaven that the scales had been tampered with, allowing Berg to come in over the contracted weight. Kid Chocolate went home to Cuba, but returned in October to box an old buddy, Benny Neighbors, who today is a postman in New York City. So the Cubans are again on the rise, sending a lot of good boxers here into New York. From Kid Chocolate's day on down, they always have been and always will be welcome. Spelled P-A-R-E-T, and of course the boys along the boxing beat have been calling him Parrot, but the Cubans, I notice, call him Paré. To go. Boys haven't lost any of their speed. They're still rambling along here. This is Madison Square Garden. This is your Gillette Cavalcade of Sports. Gaspar Ortega in white from Mexico. Kid Paré from Santa Clara, Cuba. seconds. That's the end of round nine.
Please.
Clean fight, an exciting fight, one of the best fights we've had in a long time, and we've had some good ones on the Friday night Gillette Cavalcade of Sports. You can bet they'll be matched again. What a wonderful performance.
Judge Mike Parisi, 6-4, favor of Ortega. Judge Tommy Dolan, 5-4. One even, Ortega. The referee Teddy Martin has it 6-4 in favor of Parisi. The winner by majority vote, Ortega.
Gaspar Ortega swept through most of the early rounds and defeated the favorite here tonight, Benny Parisi. One judge made it 6-4, the other judge made it 5-4, and the referee pleased the rooters here, the rather enthusiastic rooters, but Ortega was the winner all the way. Gaspar Ortega, the winner. And as I said earlier, it was such an excellent fight, I'm sure there'll be a rematch. So all three Cubans on the card tonight were defeated. Kid Paray, Douglas Bailon, and Kid Pachiki. All three Cubans were beaten tonight. Next Friday from Madison Square Garden in New York, Gillette presents a 10-round heavyweight bout.